It has given a tongue for a fox which can lick and take the soup, and a long beak for a crane which can get inside the bowl and it can drink. Both of them they can drink, but with different tools. Likewise, Vedas, Agamas, Puranas, they have different tools for different level of people. Even the great Vedic Brahmins, they have their own sources. Even a common layman, he has his own sources for the same benefit. So the Vedas are impartial. And giving different type of things to different type of people is not partiality, it is prudence. A mother giving mixed food for a newborn infant, or milk for a lactic support for the newborn infant, or a grown child being given a very well-cooked, sumptuous meal, and a semi-cooked meal for a person who is sick, and fruits and vegetables at the time of fasting or something, she is not partial, she is very prudential. Likewise, Vedas are very prudential, or they know the design of people and their capability, and nobody is denied with the result. The methodologies are different, they are getting the same benefit. So I am going to substitute with Medha and Smara Sukta the next time, or even 31st time here, I will be here for 2 or 3 days. And then it is a substitute for, there is a process, lot of things are to be dealt. It is known as ontodietrics, kindly note down ontodietrics. In the nutrition science, there is very interesting phenomena. Conversion and inversion. If unwanted things are getting inside, the resistance of the body, it can convert the unwanted things into wanted elements. Like the synaptic pruning of brain. For example, if you are having over, that is what we call hypercalcite, in which the calcium is more. At this time, if the resistance mechanism is really pure and strong and potential, the extra calcium, it is disintegrated, it is either imbibed by the body and pushed out through the excretory system, or it can be refigurated in the form of some other things like potassium, like sodium, because they are all bivalent. So they can convert into something else, and they can invent the process through excretion. And also, this type of creativity inside the body is affected by our food habits, a deviation from the morality and pathway of some sort of precision which we handled in our yester years. You follow that? Likewise, iodine and magnesium, they need not be from vegetative sources. There are 4 sources for getting energy. One is vegetative, second is organic, third is chemical, and fourth thing is energy or spiritual sources. By means of giving a potential divine command to the mind or through the consciousness, immediately that orders the brain to cook a new nutrient which is required for your body. Likewise, they have tested, for example, lot of seers, they were doing penance without any food, just by sucking air inside, just by taking dry leaves. That's what we used to say. Human beings, they are consuming food through rice. Whereas these, the bovine kingdom like cows, they consume the straw and they work more and they give good milk. And these people, they eat the rice, drink also the milk, and they work with nothing. Because it is a ratio. We are also having execution skill. Not maybe a hard work like an animal, but we are having also a smart intellectual labor which we can do. So the proportion of the work, maybe the work may be different. I don't ask, or I don't want the human beings to, pull carts like bullocks. I'm not specifying the work, nature of work. I'm specifying the proportion of work, either with your brain or with your knowledge or with your soul or anything else. The proportion is not there. Because a great tradition has been put into lapse. That we have to revive again. We cannot do in the society. Within a countable members, we can readily impart those who deserve and those who are desirous. So, from vegetative sources we can get. From organic sources we can get through animals and other things. As a non-vegetarian source. And chemical sources, it is very dangerous because chemicals, they don't react with the body with solubility. And fourth is a spiritual source by which it has been tested also. We can also test for any deficiency, like a calcium deficiency inside the body or iron deficiency in the body, either as an additive with the iron tonics like bricks, etc., or directly consuming the spiritual energy itself, we can see wondrously how that energy particles are made. But at the stage of hyper deficiency or getting into impending dangers, one must not start this practice. For the beginning level, it is okay. Somebody is about to die or about to be admitted in CCU or ICU, taking them for experimentation is experimenting his own life and your future. So So for beginning areas, it is very there. And apart from that, you can test on yourself in the case of failure or insufficiency with the medications. So these food items which we consume, they have eradicated the balance of emotions through intellect. What is the connection between this and that? As that balancing is lost, human beings like shock absorber and suspension in vehicles, they are also having suspension and shock observers. What is the shock observer of mind? That is confidence and courage. That is not a bravery with sword and fighting. That type of bravery is something to withstand occasions. And the second, what is the suspension? Suspension is faith. Faith is the suspension of human life. And faith that is coupled with courage, that is knowledgeable courage, not blind courage. I am very brave. How? I will stand before a running lorry. That is idiocy. That is not courage. Any knowledgeable, sensible, productive type of courage, which is either good to you or also to the surroundings, that must be there, coupled with faith. So faith is your suspension. Due to that mental imbalance, which is caused by the physical nutritional imbalance, which is caused by the erosion of magnesium and iron, which is caused by the kali, which may be caused by the fertilizers and the consumption and the food habitation variation and aberrations within the human being, which has been caused by the so-called imprints of the Maya Samsara, the illusory circles, the vicious circles of illusion that has contributed that. It is the hierarchy of the causative table or causation tables. So, heart is affected because we have lost these two things. Unless these two things are decided, deciphered, designed and applied or directed to the people, merely doing all of the other things like I have made the pacemaker, I am doing bypass surgery, I am doing artificial heart surgery, artificial heart implantation, these things are wrong. And these things are for interim benefits. For eternal benefits, the suspension of faith. Due to lack of faith, what happened? Everybody is, if you don't have faith, you will get into three problems. One is ambiguity in decisions, fear and suspicion. If you have fear, you cannot proceed in any walk of life. If you have suspicion, you cannot maintain good relations. If you have ambiguity, you cannot take any decisions. So this faith, you are having faith, but misplaced faith. You are having faith. Human beings, we cannot say that they don't have faith. They exactly have faith on those who are not faithful. And they don't have faith on faithful persons. So it is a misplaced or misorganized faith. So to develop faith, I want to teach you Shraddha Sukta. And for developing this type of dhairya, confidence, there is Bhayaharana Sukta. Yata dhyauscha prativicha. There are four suktas. Whatever I am going to teach you, they are just within four or five couplets. Very simple. It is not like Pratibhatashen, Bhishanavara, Gunaspama, Bhushan, like that. I don't want to put into any type of trouble. There are simpler, sweeter, shorter and smarter versions of the Vedas which I want to narrate. That require proper Uchcharana, Anucharana. You have to get the printed copies or writing of these things developed either in a magnified form, because the aksharas in the book, they are of two small font sizes. If you just magnify, you can just memorize it in a very derivable speed. So due to lack of this faith and confidence, these people, they have lost the balancing system in their life. Due to which the heart problems are there in more. So how many people are having heart problems? All people, they are having heart problems. Yes, and the heart problem, types, non-fatal, fatal and semi-fatal. In which you die is known as fatal, in which you die daily is known as semi-fatal, in which we don't die but we are disturbed is known as non-fatal. So everybody is having a heart problem. Heart problem means it must not be necessarily with some parts of the heart. Any operation of the heart. So there are also two more divisions. I always used to say generally for diseases, there are two types of cardiac patients. Those who are already cardiac patients and those who are would-be cardiac patients. Preparing for cardiac surgery or cardiac medication. So everybody, because that has become delicate in most of the people, that endurance has been totally lost in most of the people. And what is the rate of the fatal diseases? The rate of the fatal diseases is 15% of the society, global community. Especially Indians are very sentimental. Even in movies, you used to say, in Western movies, there may be a death or separation. they will cry, they will give two or three tears, then there will be a BGM, background music of a clarinet, saxophone or something else. Then it